iOS 10 is out. Here are the best features you should try now. So, getting right into it, one of the apps most people use every single day is Messages, and in iOS 10, there's a huge update. First off is Message Effects. These allow you to send messages with different effects to show different emotions. To use these, on a 3D Touch-enabled device like the iPhone 6s or 7, you just push down on the Send button to bring up the menu, and on devices without 3D Touch, you long press. From this window, you can preview many of the different bubble effects, and you can see the full screen effects. Once you find the one you like, you just hit the Send button and the recipient will see that effect on their app. There are also a few updates to Emoji. Now when you send them, they are 3 times bigger, and when you type out a message, if you hit the Emoji button, all the words that could be replaced with an emoji are highlighted, and then you can tap on them to easily change them to Emoji. There's also now digital touch in Messages, and this allows you to draw and tap messages to others, similar to what was introduced on the Apple Watch. And a huge new feature is the Messages App Store. Here, you can install packs like stickers to send, you can send them in a message or attach them to messages others have sent, and of course, this is open to third parties, so anyone can make these packs to be downloaded. And third parties can also make extensions that work inside messages, so for things like making reservations or sending money, you can do that right in the messages interface. Now, when actually using the phone, there are a bunch of new interface changes, like the lock screen. Now, there's no slide to unlock, you just use a code or Touch ID. And you can also access widgets by swiping from the left, and the camera by swiping from the right, all from the lock screen. When inside the phone, there is also a new redesigned control center with different pages for controls and music, as well as HomeKit controls. You can still access the notification center and widgets from the top, but you can also get to widgets from the home screen just by swiping from the left. Photos got some updates as well. Now there is object and facial recognition, so you can search for things in an image and photos containing those items will pop up. There's also a new feature called Memories. This goes through your images and groups them into memories based on location and time. So for instance, if you went on a trip, you'd be able to see all the best images and videos from that trip in one place. And there's also an auto-generated video that is created using those images. Overall, this is a nice way to see your images organized. Siri also got a big update. Now it works with third parties, so apps like Uber can be used with your voice without having to go into the app itself. And this works with a few different categories of apps, making it that much easier to use. Maps has also been completely redesigned. It's easier to get around and has a better navigation interface that allows you to view your route and add a destination while navigating. It will also let you find where you parked your car if you forget, and there's also third-party extensions for apps, like Uber or OpenTable, so when you're searching for directions or a location, you can quickly use those extensions in the Maps interface without having to go into a separate app. But those are some of the iOS 10 features that you should really try out. It's a huge update, so be sure to explore and see what else you find. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to subscribe so you can see when new videos are out, and visit MacRumors.com for the latest Apple news. I want to thank you all so much for watching. I'm Matt Gonzalez with MacRumors, and I'll see you next time.